What does one do when you break your spear? You gotta feed hay. You problem solve. Being a farmer, you're also a problem solver. Hope you can hear me okay. So, what I have done is devised a little plan here to get some hay off the hill instead of hauling it one at a time. So, put the loader bucket on. I got a ratchet strap. Hook it into the quick connect in the bucket. Dig it around. I hold the top in. And I got the bottom part of the belt, which is flipped up on its end, on the lip of the bucket. You can see. It near needs to be pushed up a little more. So, I don't know if this will work, but part of problem solving. So, let's see if it works. Raise the loader up some. Okay, now let's throw the bucket back. Okay, it seems to be working. Alrighty. Sometimes they work, sometimes your plans work, sometimes they don't. But you can't give up. You gotta keep going, and sometimes tighten that up a little bit. Pretty heavy. Come in here and hit this one up on the rear, and we'll go feed some cows. So I'll take y'all with me to the last day of feeding hay. So here we go. Got two of the knuckleheads in here with me. Is this gonna work?
No.
Love your honesty. All right, let me get turned around here and get situated. Got them. Got one on the back too. We're about to start our descent down off this mountain.
Down here.
Hill, whatever you want to call it.
Down here or uphill? Mm-hmm. Down here or uphill?
We're going downhill.
Like up here or downhill?
Here we go. I don't think we'll have any troubles.
You might.
The back of the tractor didn't even feel like it was light, even with them on the front without anything on the back. One thing I would worry about is I got a bad tie rod up here, and that would be the only thing that I would worry about, maybe popping out or something, breaking, anything like that. But the tractor feels fine. I'm coming down off in B range and second gear. Gonna do the first gear. We're just gonna take our time because we got two of the knuckleheads. So. Yep. So we're just gonna take it nice and easy, aren't we, kiddos? It's a steep hill. Steep enough. But anyways. See you at the bottom. Here will be the worst part of the whole trip, because there's a washout here, and I know the back end of the tractor. Okay, the front end of the tractor is going to feed right into it. I don't know if we can get out of it or not. Well, okay. I stand corrected. Right there is what I was talking about, is what I thought I'd get stuck in. Not stuck, but have to ride it all the way down through there, but I didn't. So, no worries, mate. Huh?
I way she did.
Well, you just have to take our time and just... The ditch comes out down here anyway, so... Anyways, no worries. Well, we made it down off the hill safe and sound. Yes, it's going down. See? Hey, nothing in the way. Cabs is all I'm worried about. Here. Alright. There you have it. It's time to roll them out. A little close to the fence. I think they want feed, so let's give them some feed. Come on. Another method of rolling out hay. Alrighty. End the video here, and I forgot to take you along to feed out some bag feed, so sorry about that. The cows was a little crazy. They was really wanting that feed. Of course, they're used to getting it every day. And that's the last of the hay. So that's all she wrote on that, so the cows will be turned out either tomorrow or Monday. I may hold them tomorrow and give them about a half a ton of feed, because feed is a lot cheaper than hay right now. I can buy five to six bags of feed for every roll of hay. So tomorrow I'll probably put out, let's see, 15, 16, 17, 25 bags, so that's what, 1,250 pounds. So I'll do 30 bags, and that'll get them through tomorrow, and Monday, I'll turn them out. I have no other choice. And, you know, when I turn them out, there's plenty of grass up there to eat, and they will still get their ration of the three-way mix that I feed them every day. They'll still get that, and they'll get their minerals and all they want as far as minerals goes. So it's pouring the snow. We're supposed to get 2 to 4 inches tonight, and it's supposed to be 50 degrees tomorrow, so it'll make everything nice and muddy and sloppy and everything else again. Yesterday we went to Lost Caverns, and it was 65 degrees, somewhere in that ballpark. And today is 32 degrees. It may be a little warmer than that now, probably 34. So it's just, I'm ready for spring. I'm ready for summer. I'm sick of this. Hot and cold, 60 degrees one day, 30 the next, 60 the next day, 20 the next. I've had it. Enough is enough. It's time for green grass, flowers, and leaves on the trees. So, I will leave you here at this. So, guys, thanks for watching. Thanks for subscribing. Thanks for commenting. Thanks for everything. And, I usually say, thanks for watching. Comment if you'd like, subscribe if you haven't. Until next time, and as always, later. Try not to wreck.